let's talk about the creative process, Mark, that you and I have been in. When you first walked into my studio, I thought, okay, 2 months, we're going to create this. I do very Indian specific art for Pier 1, for Walmart, all these things. And our collaboration is very much to take the whole thing geometric, to do the abstract, to do the things that people are pushing the envelope in their home, their bedroom, their tableware, the Mark Zanino and Rita Sen unique style. I thought, okay, it's going to be like 2 months, right? But then what I'm realizing is that you and I are both drilling into the problems of certain patterns mixing, and it's taking a lot more time than we both thought. Now, I'm okay with it because I understand that the creative process, even if it takes a year, it is, you got to put the hard work in. But I'm always sensitive thinking, oh, am I wasting Mark's time? And, you know, I don't want to impose on his time. So let's talk about that, you know, because I think both you and I are into the very process of doing
totally.
The hard work.
You know, but I think this is what's working, is that I'm the same way with you. Like I'm wanting, so twofold with my approach with you. I'm wanting this work. I'm wanting it, you know, I'm excited about it, but I don't want to waste your time. But I know in order for it to stick and mean something, it has to be right. We are at the foundation of what it is we're building. If we don't build it on an extremely strong foundation, it's not going to work, or it's going to fizzle out. It won't have longevity. So we're planning, you know, we're seeding this project. And this is the most important time to plant those seeds and water them and give them the proper light and to do everything so they grow and root and are strong. Then as you go up the ladder, it gets easier.
Yeah.
And so this is why, even, you know, like we're working on, you know, coloration and prints and whatever. And with anybody that I work with, some people don't get it. It's superficial. You know, why? Why do we, you know, I want to focus on something else. Why that?
Yeah.
It's a building block. It's uniqueness. You're finding your own harmony. You're finding, you know, what makes you different in the world. We're trying to create something as simple as it is, whether it's bedding or kitchen or whatever, that it makes a difference, because the world doesn't need one more of the same. They need something that's different. At least that's what people gravitate to. It's something that's a little unique, a little different, finding your specificity.
Yeah. Dennis, just to give you an idea of what goes on when Mark and I are in the design studio together, we're both running our other businesses to make sure we keep the lights on. And then every 5 minutes, he and I go back in and literally cut the clutter and zoom in on why this specific blue doesn't match with this very specific Pantone gray. Yeah. And we're able to automatically just shut off everything, despite he's getting 5 phone calls, I'm getting 5 phone calls to say that blue and that gray are absolutely not going to work.
Yeah.
So it is fascinating how the human mind, I guess, particularly in the set of a collaboration, could be manipulated and clayed and sculpted to simultaneously do a commercial enterprise and do a creative enterprise.
And we are basing it also off of innate energy, our emotional response to things. We see something, even by happenstance, we create a pattern, a coloration, whatever, and immediately we're like, oh my gosh, I love it. You know, go with it. So it is a process. And it's a feeling. I mean, you really have all your senses involved to what it is you're doing. And again, going back to clients that I work with, celebrities, whether you're a singer, whether you're an actor, whether you know, whatever it is, you're tapping into to senses that they have that I may not be built the same way or feel the same senses, but I see it in them. So our common thread is that emotional, visual, whatever connection. What's amazing with Amrita is that you wear so many hats at any given moment throughout your day. So she literally can, you know, cut with the graphics and this and go to something that is, you know, meditational music or something that's to me, it's similar. It's all the same, but I can tell for most people, they're like, you're bouncing all over the place and you're not, you're taking Amrita energy and dividing it into the world that you have around you and to the needs of that world. And I think I think that's an end result for most people, want to get to that peace of mind that they have that division, but are able to be genuine with their projects. You know, again, not faking it.
Yeah, well, actually, what does help me, and Dennis, we should get into your questions because I know you're itching to ask, is what helps me in that trying to get to that end result is thinking about something else that's existing out there and not thinking about myself. Whatever it is that is existing out there, whether it's the emotions of other people, whether it's the art in and of itself that exists like almost as a living, breathing being, whether it's kids, whether it's the children of the world, whether it's all the artists of the world who don't have what we have, don't have the abundance we have, that very much helps me constantly say, okay, what's important here? What's important in this 5 minutes that I have to dedicate to music or to dedicate to art? What's really the important thing? And it's a tool, yeah. Right? But I know people have, the tool that I've, that's really worked for me is not to think about myself at all.
Yeah.
Because whenever you start thinking about yourself, you're like, oh, that sucks.
Yeah. Well, in dealing with this, nobody will ever feel the pressure or the emotional turmoil of what you just went through with your mother dying of brain cancer.
Yes, yes.
But you still kept everything else going. And that's where, like, I was very aware of not wanting giving you the space you need emotionally, everything. And us having not known each other that long, though I feel like I've known you forever, it was understanding that process. And where I could see you are like me in that you compartmentalize the things. I can see the bond, the love you have for your family, your mother, your all of that. I mean, even at your home, it's all around. But you also have the intensity of the projects you're working on, of what you're focusing on. And it is, I can see where being able to keep working in that fashion tranquilizes you. You know, it eases your mind because your mind is able to still release, you know, whether it's worries, obligations, whatever it is that you had, you're able to hit all of that, which in turn calms you because you aren't just, you know, sitting, freaking out, spinning your wheels, you're actually accomplishing things.